God. He's always good to us. It's praise the Lord. We're so glad you're here. We're thankful to have our visitors this morning, our guests. Just make yourself at home. Worship the Lord. For He is here, and I feel Him in my soul this morning. I feel Him in the house this morning. So just magnify Him and bless His holy name. Happy Bibles. Be turning to this book of Psalms. Chapter 18. Psalm chapter 18. Before I get started, we got some new folks coming now and people joining our church. So I just want to share with you what the pastor's. Somebody said it's happening up here, and I want to rest your weary mind this morning. I'm not preaching from the internet. It's just paperless books I scroll up and down through. So we want you to rest assured of that. I want you to know I still carry my Bible that I so rely on. And also we are beginning a new journey in internet ministry, and Brother Jerry's got a website up, jerrylutheransministries.com, where he's airing the church services by video and also by audio. But I told him this morning to let's just do one service a month by video, because we don't want to I don't want you folks to quit worshiping God because the video cameras are rolling. So we want you to worship the Lord. And if there is an outbreak of the spiritual movement, we will not put that on the airwaves. That is, I believe, a man ought to be wise and do and let God do what He needs to do, the church do what we need to do. Amen. I believe we need to bless folks and not scare folks to death. Don't you? Amen. So we want to be wise in our workings for the Lord. So amen. Pray for us. We'll be having a website up and going here in the next couple of weeks. So we'll be informing you of that. So keep that in your prayers and in your minds. The first week, Brother Jerry said that he had 662 people to visit the website. 50 people the first week viewed our telecast that we did last Sunday. So praise God for that. Amen. I believe in getting the word out however we can, don't you?
Amen.
Oh, come on, say amen. Amen. 21st century. Hallelujah. Amen. You turn on your TV and watch it every morning. So why shouldn't we go ahead and join in and get the word out there so people can enjoy Jesus Christ and what we do for Him? Amen. Praise God. So mostly, let's worship God this morning. Psalm 18, verses 1 through verse 6. I know the Lord has a word for somebody, because the devil fought all day yesterday. Hallelujah. I got in the office at about 8:45. Somewhere around 3:30, I just threw my hands up. Said, I got to get out of here. I knew what I wanted to preach on, but it just wasn't coming together. And so I had to just get out. I told my wife, I said, I just need to get away and let something fresh comes. So the Lord help me. You know, sometimes you can study too much and too hard. Amen. Sometimes you get so wrapped up you can't hear from the Holy Spirit of God. Amen. So we trust that God's going to help someone this morning. Psalm 18, verse 1, reading from the King James. It says, I love thee, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer. My God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my buckler in the horn of my salvation and my high tower. I will call upon the Lord who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. The sorrows of death compassed me, and the floods of ungodly men made me afraid. The sorrows of hell compassed me about, the snares of death prevented me. In my distress I called upon the Lord and cried unto my God. And he heard my voice, and out of his temple, and my cry came before him, even into his ears. I want you to know this morning the Lord hears your cry. Amen. When you call on Him, even though you might not realize it, the Lord hears you when you cry. Amen. But I want to speak to you this morning with this thought that the Lord is my fortress. Amen. The Lord is my fortress. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we come before You again this morning. So thankful to be able to be in Your house. So thankful to have the privilege to be here. Lord, You use us this morning to touch the people here in this building today, God, and instruct them, encourage them, build up their hope, build up their faith, God, so that we can fight another battle tomorrow. But God, as sure as we go out of the door, we're going to face the devil head on, and God, we need the power and the Spirit of God to help us to overcome our enemy. And God, we're so thankful, God, that You are our fortress today, and we praise You for that. In the name of Jesus Christ, and we give You honor in Jesus' lovely name. Amen. You may be seated when you can. Praise God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I found this word while studying. It's called Migdol. Migdol. It is the ordinary Canaanite word for watchtower. It means tower, small fortress, watchtower. And in Genesis 11:14, the scripture tells us, and they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower, whose top may reach unto the heavens. And then these people tried to build a temple unto heaven. They tried to make it in their own wisdom, in their own doings. They tried with all their strength and their mind. Listen to me this morning, church. God gave us a way unto heaven. We don't have to construct a way. There is already a way unto heaven. And His name is Jesus Christ. For He is the way, the truth, and the life. And He is the only way. Amen. That way is Christ. And the only love these verses that we're going to share with you this morning. Amen. For the Lord is our high tower this morning. In 2 Samuel 22, verse 3, the Bible says, the God of my rock, in Him will I trust. He is my shield and my horn of my salvation, my high tower and my refuge, my Savior. Thou savest me from violence. In Psalm 18:2 that we just read, it said, the Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my buckler and the horn of my salvation and my high tower. Amen. In Psalm 144, verse 2, 1 and 2, the Bible tells us, blessed be the Lord my strength, which teacheth my hands to war and my fingers to fight, my goodness and my fortress, my high tower and my deliverer, my shield, and he in whom I trust, who subdueth my people under me. Amen. God is our high tower, church. Amen. That stands high above all that there is. The Lord sits on His heavenly throne, and He looks down, and because of His elevation, He sees where we're at, knows where we are, and knows what we're going through. Amen. Not only that, He had a plan to help us to make it to where He wants us to go, and to help us to get there, because He is high and lifted up and seated at the right hand of the Father. He helps us because He knows our way and knows our thoughts and can help us. Not only that, He sees the enemy when he's coming against you. Amen. When they built a fortified city, when they built walls around it, amen, they built high towers so that they could put outlookers up there to keep watch out for the enemy, so that they could know when the enemy was coming to try to do harm to the city. So Jesus sets Himself up as our high tower to look out for the enemies who might be coming against your soul this morning. And let me tell you, He's after your soul this morning. He's out to get you, to take you under. And that's why Jesus is still sitting on the throne looking out for your good and for my good. Hallelujah. To His name. Amen. Before the trouble comes in your life. Amen. God sees it. It's wonderful. Amen. That God can see the whole situation and know and develop a plan to help us make it through our troubles and struggles. Oh, hallelujah. Even though we may not know it, the Lord has already, the Bible says, that He has ordered our steps. Amen. He knows where He wants us to go, so He has already mapped out the plan for us. Amen. Hallelujah. Through His name, He can see the way, amen, out of the mysteries of our life. Amen. He knows the answers to the problems before the problems ever arise in our lives. He knows how to help us. The problems
Amen. I didn't know I would be in the places that I be because he doesn't give us that foresight to know where he wants us to go. All he gives us is faith in him, to trust him, to lead us where he is wanting us to go, the things he wants us to do. Amen. The reason that the problems arise and the storm clouds set in our lives are of lengthy periods from time to time is that sometimes we don't take our troubles to the watchtower. Amen. We don't take our troubles to the Lord. Amen. If we go to him in the beginning of our sorrow, he might devise a plan to get us out quicker than we normally would if we don't go to him. Amen. Lord, hallelujah. That's why he told us in his word to bring all your burdens to me and lay them down. Bring all your trouble to me and I shall give you rest. Amen. When we bring them to him, he takes care of our problems and troubles. Hallelujah. Through his holy name. Amen. Glory to God. We need to get in touch with the high tower. His name is Jesus. Amen. Do you pray daily? Amen. Do you pray every day and seek his face and for the troubles you go through? Amen. That's the trouble. Amen. That's the reason Christians are failing and falling is because they do not call on the Lord Jesus daily in their lives. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. We need to get a hold of Jesus. Amen. I read a study one time where it said they did a poll on Christians and ministers of how many minutes they prayed a day. And when they got to the ministers, it was a little better than the normal Christian, but the pastors only prayed like 5 minutes a day. And we wonder why churches are falling apart, why Christian lives are falling apart. If we don't talk to the one who has designed us, how can we know what he wants us to do? Hallelujah. So we must call on Jesus Christ. The word fortress, amen, it often refers to a small fortress. In Judges 8, verses 8 and 9, the Bible tells us, and Gideon, amen, went up thence to Peniel and spake unto them likewise. And the men of Peniel answered him as the men of Succoth had answered him. And he spake also unto the men of Peniel, saying, when I come again in peace, I will break down this tower. What he was saying, I'm going to tear this fortress down. He came to them seeking for food and bread for his army, and they were forbid it. They didn't want to give them food. But he says, okay, that's what you want to be. The next time I come, I'm not only going to come in peace, but I'm coming to destroy this little fortress you're hiding behind. Amen. And they did. Glory to God. In Psalms 31, verse 3, the Bible says, for thou art my rock and my fortress, therefore, for thy name's sake, lead me and guide me. Oh, hallelujah. We need his leadership, don't we? We need his guidance in everyday life to know how to fight this good fight of faith that we're in. Amen. There were three people. Amen. One of the people built their house on their own strength. They put every bit of their strength into it. All the power that they could muster up was placed in this house. Amen. But the one day Satan came by, amen, and he tested the strength of this house. And even though the persons used every ounce of might that they had, amen, it wasn't a match to the strength of Satan. And he destroyed the house. Amen. The second man, he built his house with great wisdom. Amen. He thought everything out. He depended on the great wisdoms of the world and the greatest educations that he could find. And the house that he built looked great. Everything looked positively great. Amen. But because of the wisdom that the person had, everything looked like that it was the real thing, the real deal. Amen. They had everything in place. It seems as if the house had everything going for it. However, then Satan came along, amen, and he tried the foundations of the home. And with the stress of the world and Satan was overwhelming, the house began to crumble and tumble down because of the power of the enemy. But then the third person, he tried something very different from all the other two. He allowed God to build his house. He let the Lord's will be done in his life and in the house. God's protection, God's power, God's wisdom was able to build a house that was strong and could stand whatever the devil could throw at it. Amen. Let me tell you, the Lord said, if the Lord doesn't build a house, then it cannot be built. Amen. We must They could race chariots three abreast on top of this wall. They thought they were inside this secure so that no one could get to them. Amen. But they didn't know the plan of the Lord. Amen. They didn't know who was working against them. Amen. And Jesus sent out his servant Joshua. And he said, go and take the city. And Joshua said to the father, how would you listen to God? He'll give you a plan for whatever's going on in your life. Just go up to Jericho. Amen. Just go up there. Take seven trumpets and seven priests and march around this thing seven times in 7 days. Amen. And on the seventh day. Amen. Let no one speak until that seventh day. And on the seventh time round. Amen. Give a shout unto the Lord. And when they shouted and blew the trumpet, amen, the walls crumbled down. Why? Because God said it would. Amen. And God told him to. Amen. Because the people were obedient unto the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And so he called victory to come to their house. Amen. Amen. I read another story this morning. Kings chapter 7. The Syrians had come against the city of Samaria. Amen. And they had them besieged in there for so many days. Amen. And the Bible said that a donkey's head sold for such and such, and the dove's dung sold for a certain amount. Amen. But then the prophet Elisha come by and he said, let me tell you, he said, on this certain day, amen, this is going to sell for that and this for that. Plenty is coming, is what he was telling them, but they didn't believe it. And on the outside, there were four lepers out there. Amen. Sitting outside waiting for somebody to bring them a morsel of food. Amen. And once all of a sudden, they said one day, they said, I said, we here and die. They said, at least we can go down to the enemy's camp, which was just a few miles down the road. They said, let's go there. Either we, at least we can be satisfied when they give us. Amen. And so I went over there. You ever know four people could make so much racket? The Bible says when the enemy heard them coming, it sounded like an army marching to their position. And they got scared and fled. They left their tents, they left everything there, and they left. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, and my father used to take me in the woods, squirrel hunting. He'd make me walk behind him. He said, we've got to be real quiet. He said, you've got to walk softly and be real quiet. And every now and then he'd turn around and say, shh. You sound like hell going through the woods. Maybe these elephants sound like elephants coming their way. I don't know. But God called the great noise to go before them. Why? Because they chose, amen, to go not down where they were, but to go do something about their position. Amen. And God used these four lepers to bring victory to a city of Samaria. Amen. Oh, hallelujah to this day. Why? Because four men chose to listen to the leadership of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And take them down to the enemy's camp. And God brought victory to their journey. Amen. Well, there was another one in 2 Kings chapter 32. King Hezekiah is besieged by Sennacherib, king of Assyria. Amen. And they were there for many days and many weeks. Amen. And they said, Sennacherib said, well, we're just going to starve you out. And then one of the pastors mentioned the other night at school. He said, I saw a sign upon a place where I went in. It said, how to conquer a fortress. He said, the first thing you do is you take their guns away. You take their fire away. Then you take their food away. Then you take their spirit away. Amen. So this is what Sennacherib was trying to do. He was trying to break their spirit and bring hunger upon them so that they would give in unto him. Amen. Glory to God. You know what Hezekiah did? The Bible said Hezekiah went unto the Lord. And Hezekiah prayed. Amen. And got a hope of the Lord Jesus Christ, God Almighty. And God sent victory to their journey. Amen. The Bible said that the Lord sent an angel to destroy, amen, the Assyrians. And drove them away. And God brought victory to the city of Samaria. Hallelujah. He'll do the same for you if we will allow him to. Listen, there's not another way of building God's house or his kingdom, amen, or God's temple except through God's way. It is through him that we build and do what we do. Hallelujah. Through his glorious name. Amen. Hallelujah. Listen to what 1 Peter, verse 1 in chapter 1, 3 and 5 says. Blessed be the the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, through an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in the heavens for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last days. Romans 8:38-39 says, Amen, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principality, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, neither height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. I want you to know Jesus is your strong tower, he is your fortress, and the enemy cannot get to you if you are in Jesus Christ. Amen? Hallelujah. Yes, we go through struggle. Yes, we'll go through some hard times. But the enemy cannot conquer us because we are in the fortress of Jesus Christ, and he shall secure us with his own hand. Amen. Oh, hallelujah to his holy name. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. A lot of people worry about what people think about them or what people say about them. Amen. What the devil's going to do. Amen. Hallelujah. Listen, some of you are in your own fortress, and you've secured yourself in your own fortress. And every time the devil hollers boo, you get frightened and scared. It seems like sometimes that on every hand the enemy's trying to get to you, on every hand, and you get fearful and you get weak because of the enemy threatenings against you. Amen. But let me tell you, amen, if we're in Jesus Christ, you don't have to worry about the enemy. Amen. When people talk about me, say things about me, I don't let it bother me because I know in whom I am, amen, and in whom I belong, and I know people fight my battle for me, so why should I worry about what someone else is doing or saying? Because it's all brought about by the devil, amen, and that's all he's trying to do is destroy us through fear and other things that come our way. That's why we need to trust in Jesus. Glory to God. Trust in him. We should be able to lay our head down at night and feel safe and secure, amen, as we ever have. Amen. What better security can you have than in the Lord being your fortress this morning? Amen. First, 2 Thessalonians 3 and verse 3 tells us, but the Lord is faithful, who shall establish you and keep you from evil. Hallelujah. Amen. He will protect you. So don't fret and worry over what the enemy is doing against you. Amen. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. God has built walls of love all around you. Amen. Praise the Lord that he cares for you that much. Amen. He has built the fortress so strong, amen, and so secure that nothing can get in, amen, except what we allow to come in. Amen. And you can go to bed and lay with whatever you want to. You can go to bed, worry about this, worry about that, let it mess up your mind, mess up your sleep. Amen. Well, you just need to tell the devil, just go back where he come from and go on to sleep. Amen. When he brings these things to me, I just like that shit. Forget you, I'm going to sleep. The Holy Spirit will take care of you, brother. Amen. And so I go on to sleep and let God do what he can in me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So we need to trust him and magnify his holy name. Glory to God. He has you secured in his hands, and all we have to do is come before him and trust him to do what he is able to do. Amen. Problem is our faith, it's weak. Amen. When we see the enemy coming, fear grips us, and we get weak and anemic because we lack the word of God. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. When you get this word of God on the inside of you, and you read it, and you meditate upon it, and you hide it in your heart that you might not sin against God, then when the enemy comes, you've got something to fight with. Amen. Well, whenever they took fortresses in the Old Testament, they had some weaponry to fight with. That one scripture I'm telling you, that in Psalm it said, the Lord taught my hands to war and my fingers to battle. He will teach you on how to fight this fight that we are in. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Well, they had battering rams. Amen. They had archers that shot the bows. Amen. And they built up
Bless his name.
We call sometimes these the watchtower. Amen. Especially fortified towers safeguarding the gates. Amen. In the 2 Chronicles 26 and verse 9, the Bible says, moreover, Uzziah built towers in Jerusalem at the corner gate, at the valley gate, and at the corner of Buttress, and fortified them. 2 Chronicles 16 and 9 says, for the eyes of the Lord run to and fro through the whole earth to show himself strong in the behalf of those whose heart is perfect toward him. He's fighting for you. He's running to and fro. Amen. To get against the enemy of your soul and to keep him out of your life. He is your high tower. Amen. And your fortress this day. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Tower in the Greek means a fortified structure rising to a considerable height to repel a hostile attack, or to enable a watchman to see in every direction. The Tower of Siloam seems designate a tower in the walls of Jerusalem. Amen. Near the fountain of Siloam in Luke 13 and verse 4. It is watchtowers that are fortified. Amen. In the frontier, an exposed situation. Amen. They are mentioned in Scripture. Amen. And they teach us that Jesus is our high tower who watches out for our good. We need him today. Amen. Such towers are still in use in Palestine, in the vineyards, especially near Hebron, and are used as lodges for keepers of the vineyards. High towers were meant for people to keep watch over the enemy, over animals coming into their vineyards and things. And so Jesus sets up the high towers to watch over the enemies. Amen. They set up the towers to defend whales and flocks or commerce. Amen. Also attached to vineyards as lodges for the keepers, wherein there could watch against the depredations of man or beast. Amen. Glory to God. Jesus watches over us against man or beast. Amen. Whatever the enemy comes against your soul, Jesus is watching out for you and for your good. And he's going to do everything he can to help you this day. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God is there to defend us from every tyrant of this world. He is our watchtower, our strong fortress. God is watching over us all the time, day and night. Amen. He never goes to sleep on his job. He loves you so much. He is constantly protecting you according to Isaiah 43 and verse 2, which says, when thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. Amen. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. Amen. Psalms 3 and verse 3 says, but thou, O Lord, art a shield for me, my glory and the lifter upper of my head. Hallelujah. He will hold your head up high. Glory to God. And he will allow you. You don't have to go around with your head hanging down because you belong to the child of the king. So amen. Take pride and lift your head up in knowing that you are a child of the king. Hallelujah. Exodus 23 and 22 says, but if thou shalt indeed obey his voice and do all that I speak, then I will be an enemy unto thine enemies and an adversary unto thine adversaries. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. I wish you could get these in your spirit and take them to heart and believe in what God is telling you today. Amen. We need to praise the Lord for his goodness for all times. Amen. He is constantly watching out for our good. He is always defending us. He protects us and loves us. He defends our honor. Amen. In every moment, God is truly our all in all. When we allow him to see, he knows who we are. He knows what we need, and he knows how to get us where he wants us to be and what he desires in us. Amen. So all we have to do is trust in him. Hallelujah. Let us fear the name of the Lord from the west and his glory from the rising of the sun. Amen. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall rise up a standard against him. Glory to God. Thank God that he is our watchtower. Amen. He is constantly watching over his church. Glory to God. Amen. God is our fortress that defends our soul. And in the wiles of the devil that they come against us, he is the defender of your soul. So trust him with all of your heart. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. What a bodyguard of the soul. Amen. Glory to God. And everywhere you go, you have a body part. Amen. The Lord Jesus Christ is going with you to defend you. Amen. Is it no wonder that we can have a peace that passes all understanding when we have a Father like we have, the Lord Jesus, amen, that can see all things, know all things, and do all things, and take care of our every need. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. Amen. That gives us room to praise Him, doesn't it? Amen. Do you truly trust Him this morning? Is He your fortress of protection? Have you entered into the ark of God's safety? Amen. Let God put His arms of love around you this morning. Amen. His mercy around you and protect you from the world, from Satan, and from yourself. Amen. Sometimes we need saving from ourselves. Yeah. Amen. Sometimes I'm my worst enemy. Hallelujah. Well, how do you say that? Because sometimes I allow my mind to go places it ought not to go. And think things it ought not to think. And do things it ought not to do. Amen? So that's why that I must come to the Lord daily in His Word and in prayer. And God to watch over me. Help me. Watch over my mind. Guard my mind. Guard the thoughts of my mind and of my mouth. And help me to be holy and pure in Your sight. Amen? That's why we need the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. We wish to praise Him, our Heavenly Father, this morning, and give Him glory and honor for all that He does. Amen. He is able to help us. We thank You this morning, Lord, for defending us, for taking care of us. Help us to learn not to depend upon our own wisdom, but upon the wisdom of God Almighty. Help us to truly depend on His goodness and His mercy and His grace to help us throughout the days that we live. Amen. He is our tower, church. Amen. And our fortress that keeps us safe from the evils of this world. Amen. So trust in Him and light up by His wonderful name. Musicians, come on to the piano. Glory to God. He is your fortress this morning, church. And your high tower. Amen. We don't always know what to do. We don't always know how to act. Amen. But we do know when we go to the Word of God and when we go to prayer that the Lord strengthens us and helps us to fight the good fight of faith. Amen. The devil is trying to secure your fortress. He's trying to take away your fight. Amen. He's trying to take away your praise and your adoration unto the Lord. Amen. He's trying to take away your praying and your reading of Scripture. Amen. He's trying to take away your joy and your happiness. Amen. So we need to learn how to fight against Him. Amen. To take out the weaponry. Amen. The battering ram of prayer and praise and calling on the Lord Jesus Christ to help us. Amen. And He will when we call on His name. Glory to God. Stand in your feet this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He is my strong tower. He is my fortress. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says that you shall go in and out in fine pasture. Amen. When the enemy comes in like a flood, we can run into the fortress of Jesus Christ. And He will help us all along the way. All we have to do is trust in Him. Put our faith in Him. And He shall help us. Amen. The enemy is going to try you today, and tomorrow, the following day. So put your trust in Him. Before you go out the door of the morning, you ought to have read at least a passage of Scripture and pray for the Lord to give you safety and guidance for that day, to let you be a blessing to the world around you. Amen. You know, the Lord didn't leave us here on earth to see what we can get in this life. He leaves us here to make a difference in the world. Who can I help? Who can I bless? Who can I make a difference in someone's life? Or how can I make a difference in someone's life? And we do that by the help of the Lord Jesus Christ. When we start out our day with prayer and seek Him, He will lead us to the rock that is higher than we are and cause us to be victorious throughout life. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes I look at some of you and I wonder how you make it through your struggles. How do you make it through the problems of life? And then all I have to do is look unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. And he promises us when we call on him that he will be a present help in the time of trouble. And all we have to do is call on his name, and he shall show up and help his children. Hallelujah to his name. So put your hope in him and your faith in him, and God will come to your rescue. Hallelujah. And you know, because he's never failed me. Every time I call on him, he comes. And if he doesn't speak through the Spirit, he speaks through the Word and helps me along the way. Amen. This book is full of help and hope if we only use it for our advantage. You see, the sinner doesn't have the roadmap of life. He only has what the world offers. You and I have got the precious book of life. Tells us how to win. Tells us how to be victorious. All we have to do is read. Greatest love story ever told. How that God came from heaven to save man. Oh, hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I once was lost. But now I'm found. Hallelujah. I once had no hope, but now there is hope in Christ Jesus. So trust him today. Magnify his name. If you need prayer this morning, every head bowed, every eye closed. You've never been saved. The Lord's dealing with your heart. And I invite you to come and receive the Lord as your Savior. Maybe you're just not where you need to be living with the Lord. And you need strength. You need power from on high. Then you come and allow them and renew your relationship with the Lord Jesus. Or maybe you're sick in body. Maybe you're just discouraged. Or maybe the enemy's coming against your soul and you just need strength to make it. Then you come and let us lift you up unto the Lord for strength and for help throughout these days that we live. You need him and he needs you. So if you need prayer, you come this morning. Hallelujah. To his holy name. He's here and I believe in my heart. Feel that tugging and the wooing of the sweet Holy Spirit. He wants to help you if you will allow.